Okay, so since posting my original videos on the black seed honey concoction for the potential cure of HIV, a lot of questions I've gotten from people is, how do you actually mix the black seeds and honey together in the right combination? So in this video, I'm going to show you how to mix it together, and I'm going to use the exact amounts that were used in the clinical research. And at the end of this video, I'm also going to answer some other common questions that people have asked me along the way. And if you're encountering this for the very first time, I will link to my other black seeds and honey HIV reviews so you can see the actual clinical research for yourself. Okay, so before you go any further, the thing to know is that the black seed and honey is mixed in a 60-40 combination. This means that 60% of this concoction is made up of black seeds and 40% of it is made up of honey. And if we look at the original research on this, they actually used 6 kilograms of black seeds, and these were then ground into a fine powder using a mortar and a pestle. Now, once you have that done, you mix the black seeds with 4 liters of honey. And the research papers don't specify any specific brand of honey other than to say it's newly harvested and it is pure. That means that potentially store-bought brands that have been processed may not do the same thing as the honey that they're recommending here. Now, once you mix the black seeds and honey together, this is going to form a paste. That paste is then stored in a jar and it is covered. They don't say whether or not this mixture is refrigerated. However, that might be something to consider if you're gonna be storing this for long periods of time. Now, when you're ready to use the black seed and honey mixture, you're gonna take out 10 milliliters and you're gonna combine that with 50 milliliters of warm water. And the amount of the black seed and honey mixture that they're using in the research comes to 10 milliliters used 3 times per day. So when you mix everything together with the warm water, that's gonna come to about 1 tablespoon that is used, again, 3 times per day. Okay, so that's what they use in the research, but what if you wanted to make less and just make it as you go along? So for example, what if you only wanted to make 1 gallon of the black seed and honey concoction? So 1 gallon comes to 3,782 milliliters, and 60% of that, which would be the black seed portion, would come to 2,269. As for the honey portion, it would be 40% of 3,782. That would be 1,512. And just as before, you would mix the black seeds and honey together, you would cap it, you would store it, and you would use 10 milliliters mixed with 50 milliliters of water every time you wanted to use it. And again, the dosage that was used in the original research was 10 milliliters used 3 times per day, which again comes to about 1 tablespoon that was taken 3 times per day. So that's how you basically put it together. But let me now answer some questions that have been asked to me in the comments of other videos that I've done previously on this topic. For example, can you use black seed oil instead of black seeds? And I would say that there's nutrients in black seed oil. However, across the board, the research on black seed and honey used black seeds and not the oil. So if this alleged cure really does work, the oil may not do the same thing. Now, they don't mention any specific brand of black seeds other than to say in one of the papers that the black seeds were obtained from a market in Kano, which is a region of northern Nigeria. And my hunch is that they chose that market because it was probably close by to where the original research was conducted. Likewise, again, they don't mention any specific brand of honey other than to say it was newly harvested and pure, and that's all they say. So local honey that is not ultra processed would probably be something you might want to look at if you're going to try this. Now, I believe they're using warm water because it helps the black seed and honey paste mix together easily. They're not mentioning in the research the specific temperature of the water. They also don't say if the water is tap water or distilled water. Additionally, they don't say that the water has to come from a special part of the world, and they don't say anything about the water being blessed either. As for where the 60-40 combination of black seeds and honey came from, that also is not alluded to in any of the papers that I saw. So could a 50-50 mixture or a 70-30 mixture do the same thing? nobody, to my knowledge, has tested any other ratios other than a 60-40 combination. And where that came from is your guess is as good as mine. And again, the research is using a 60-40 combination of black seeds and honey mixed with about 50 milliliters of water. That comes to about one tablespoon that is used 3 times per day. And also, if this research is to be believed, it's going to take several weeks to several months, maybe as much as 6 months, before you might start seeing improvements in CD4 counts and other HIV symptoms.